Praise God. Welcome back to my channel. I am born again. I love Jesus as my personal savior. He has continued to be my source of life, and I no longer live it, but Christ lives in me through the power of the Holy Spirit. He is the one who lives in me. I want us to share the word of God in Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 12. For we are not fighting against human beings, but against the wicked spiritual forces in the heavenly world, the rulers, authorities, and cosmic powers of this dark age. Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 12. Today my topic is spirit of stagnation or backwardness. I want us to talk about this, because in my other video I talked about dreams, and as part of the dreams we are warned about the spirit of stagnation. And this is how you know that you're being attacked by the devil, by stagnating your life or by making you remain in the same position or go back to your village or to the old life that you used to be. If you are dreaming anything concerning your past, for example, you dream about yourself in the primary school you were in, or in the dress you used to wear, or in the uniform you used to wear in primary school, in secondary, or in your college or university, and you're advanced, you're not in that level anymore, know that this is an attack by the enemy. If you dream about an old place you used to live, maybe a house you used to live in, if you're dreaming about anything about your past, know that the devil is attacking you by holding you back. He doesn't want you to progress. He's holding you back and stagnating your life. So you need to be wise and make a prayer to break from that spirit. It's called the spirit of stagnation or backwardness. So if you're dreaming about anything about your past, know that the spirit of stagnation is after you, is against your life, is attacking your life. And this makes you not to move forward, not to progress. You try in business, you do all that you have to do, but there's a spirit that's holding you back. The Bible says that we are not fighting against flesh and blood, but against spiritual forces. So if we are fighting against spiritual forces and the spirit of stagnation is fighting you, you need to fight it back. You need to fight it back so that you defeat it. When you defeat the spirit of stagnation, you're able to move forward and break forth to another level. That's why if you're in business, your business is not progressing, and this issue, when you're making your prayers well, but you're dreaming about primary school, secondary school, something you already left, something you even moved on from, a village you stayed, a plot you stayed in, you're dreaming about those people. God is giving you a notice that whatever is holding you back is this spirit, and this is what you need to directly fight so that you're able to move forward, so that your business can progress. So you're dreaming about any past issues in your life, in anything that concerns you. Maybe you dream with your old friend. You may no longer even be communicating, but you dream with her or with him in a place you used to do things. That's a spirit of stagnation, and you need to rebuke it completely. We have the power and authority in the word of God. So it's not a physical fight. You just attack it directly by the word of God. Psalms 35 is a very powerful prayer to fight the evil spirits that fight us. So use Psalms 35, Psalms 70, Psalms 91. These are all powerful, powerful prayers, and many others that you know you can add. Pray against the spirit of stagnation. If you have to, you can pay a sacrifice, because you don't know who is fighting you and what they have paid as a sacrifice in the in the evil world. So you can pay a sacrifice if you feel you need to plant a seed so that you are disconnected completely and you're able to move forward. The desire and the will of God for our lives is that we move from one level of glory to another, not to stay in the same position. So if you find yourself that your business is not growing, or whatever you're trying, your career is stuck, your level of education is not moving, and the dreams you're having most of the times is about your primary school, your past, things about your past, know that the spirit of stagnation is fighting you. So you need to fight it back with prayer. And the Bible says, not by power, not by might, but the spirit of God. We are able to defeat and move forward. We break that and we move forth by the power of the Spirit of God. He is there to fight for you and to give you the backup that you need. You just need to know that what you are attacking is this. That's why you're having the warning, the dreams, so that you realize, you recognize this. The Bible says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. So this is a simple thing that will keep holding you back forever. As you dream, you don't know the meaning of the dream. But if you know, when you know it, you're able to break forth and move to the next level. So we need this knowledge. That's why I'm sharing this video. When you watch it and you find it is helping you, share with somebody else that they may get to know this information, that they be able to fight in the right way with wisdom. Because the Bible says we perish for lack of knowledge. Before I knew this, I was dreaming such things. I didn't know what the meaning was. So I watched somebody else and I realized, oh, this is what it means. Okay, now I know. I need to share this with somebody else that they can help, they can be helped and not be stagnated in the same place forever. So when you watch this video, share with somebody else. They may benefit and learn and move forward and get something that God has in store for us. May the Lord God Almighty bless you and disconnect you from every evil spiritual attack against your life. Any spirit of stagnation or backwardness that is holding you back, the Lord is able to break it. And this is my prayer for you, that God sets you free from any bondage in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Please like, share and subscribe for more and more videos. See you in my next video. God bless you. Much love.